You used me! You told me what I wanted to hear to get me to pull that f***ing omit!
Nice.
I am going to guarantee I will get your ass.
Ask me which reality TV show has made it to the limelight without awkward moments, and I'll confidently tell you, none. And so is the case for our favorite, 90 Day Fiancé, which has so far captured the attention of many, leaving them with those wow moments. If you're interested just like I am to find out which unbelievable moments are captured in 90 Day Fiancé, then be sure to watch this video till the end as we do the countdown. Number 10. Darcy Gets Drunk. Well, talking of alcoholism in the entire 90 Day Fiancé, and what comes to mind is Darcy. Throughout the entire show, we get to encounter Darcy in a big awkward mess just because of her reckless drinking. She gets fully intoxicated, and this is where the whole mess begins. Talk of her relationship with Jesse, and the answers come to a total mess. She drinks more than she can stand, and eventually gets into fights or falling over drunk. Now, the most unbelievable moment that her alcoholism lands her is when she tries to seduce Tom by throwing her legs in the air and exposing her underwear while fully drunk. You can't wish to miss her in any of the seasons, because her antics are just shocking. Number 9. Paula is not welcomed by Russ's family. What do you do when your in-laws denounce you? Well, that is exactly what happened to Colombian beauty Paula when she moved to Oklahoma to stay with her fiancé, Russ. It happened that the situation turned tense between the couple and Russ's conservative parents. And on Paula's first arrival, Russ made it clear that his parents weren't completely supportive of their relationship, saying, "I know that they are hesitant about my engagement with Pau." However, the wow moment came when they were having a family meal together at home, and Russ's parents just revealed they were uncomfortable with Paula by keeping silent throughout the meal. But Paula, who felt disturbed, just intervened by asking Russ's parents what they thought of their engagement. The mother sarcastically answered, the joke was when he first left, was, "You know, don't go down there falling in love and, you know, bring a girl back home." Sure enough, he does. Who does that? She just confirmed that Russ brought Paula home against her wish. Later, the two lovebirds relocated from Russ's family home to Miami. But of course, after Paula had undergone several tense interactions from her conservative in-laws. Number 8. Lita and Eric argue about child support. When it comes to child support, some parents are fast to deny the responsibility. But a child will always remain a child, and parents must cater to their responsibilities. This is the situation Eric and Lita gets into. Indonesian beauty queen Lita in season 6 brings her young son to Wisconsin to be with fiancé Eric. But then it becomes difficult for the two families to bond. So, Lita demands for Eric's daughter to be moved out of the apartment they shared, besides complaining about Eric's role to pay child support for his other kids. However, drama ensues when Eric fails to buy Lita the cozy furniture she wanted. They get into a nasty insults exchange. Lita goes on to refer to his daughter as a burden, but then Eric defends his children, saying, "In America, family is what matters." This seems to anger Lita even more, who fumes, "Then I don't want to get married then." Eric jumps in to ask, "Because of child support?" And surprisingly, Lita's answer, "Yeah." Very nasty indeed. However, the two finally get married, but Lita's issues with Eric's children continue. Eventually, the court slams Lita with a restraining order against Eric's daughter, Tasha. Number 7. Mohammed and Danielle talked about sex. To increase affection between him and his fiancée Danielle, Mohammed moves from Tunisia to Ohio to be with her. But this doesn't work, even as their relationship issues escalate with threats of a breakup. They finally end up as separated, but still legally married couples. In the season 2 finale at the tell-all episode, the rift between Danielle and Mohammed increases, forcing moderator Sean Robinson to intervene. And when Sean asked if there was intimacy between them after the wedding, the couple ends up spilling their dirty linen on what can be described as the dirtiest sex talk ever in TLC history. "There was, but we started facing a problem," Mohammed responded immediately, claiming Danielle would beg for sex, allegedly screaming, "I want my sex tonight," and threatening to deport him. This was indeed unbelievable. Number 6. Mark scolded his 19-year-old fiancée Nikki like she was his daughter. Now, talking of the age gap in marriage, and Mark and Nikki's will surely shock you. The two had a huge age difference. She was 19 when he was 58. Isn't it strange to call that a couple? Ideally, it better fits a daughter-father relationship. But Mark would take advantage of his advanced age to treat Nikki as his daughter than a fiancée. So, it got nasty that at one point when he picked her up from the airport, Nikki admired the sights from the car window touching the window. And boy, Mark did not take it lightly. He cautioned Nikki like his kid, "You putting fingerprints on my windows?" This got Nikki confused. He continued to warn her that she shouldn't put her fingers on the windows, and that this was a rule he had for his children. But Nikki retaliates by putting her whole hand on the window. Mark responded with, "Nikki, you're messing with my happiness." Well, nothing gets better than watching this couple on their day-to-day activities. Number 5. Andre snatches Elizabeth's phone. Some of the most uncomfortable scenes we've witnessed in 90 Days Fiancé have been enacted by Andre and Elizabeth. However, one scene seems to have outdouched them all. Now, after Elizabeth involves in an argument with her sister due to Andre's missing motivation and negligence to his pregnant wife, Andre gets saddened and picks up Libby. But as he's discussing how to get over the issue, Libby starts to text her sisters, and this upsets Andre even more. While still driving, Andre orders Elizabeth to put her phone down and stop texting. Drama escalates even as Andre insists, "Don't respond, I said." Andre forcibly snatches the phone from her paws. Interestingly, Elizabeth snaps it back. Number 4. Carolina finds underwear in fiancé's closet. In Season 3, Carolina arrives in the U.S. from Colombia, certain that their relationship with her fiancé, Fernando, will work. He knew him as a cheater before, and so she was keen to check for any possible sign of cheating. Surprisingly, when Carolina looks for drawers in Fernando's home, she finds a pair of pink panties in the closet. "This is for a girl," Carolina said while raising the panty. Now when Fernando is invited from upstairs to explain, he defends himself in a nervous, awkward way, saying, "That has nothing. That's nothing from recent. That's old. I'm serious. It happened so many years ago that I can't even remember who they're from or what they are." Well, such an awkward moment indeed, but the two eventually end up getting married. Number 3. Paul wears a condom to go swimming. In Season 1 of the show, we see Paul travel to Brazil to meet his prospective fiancée, Karine, whom he met on the internet. It was not a comfy encounter as they had a language barrier and had to use an app for translation. However, the situation became weird when the two decided to go swimming. Now, before getting into the water, Paul told Karine that his doctor had warned him against drinking and swimming in the Brazilian water. He then pulled out what he referred to as a sheath protection bag. He headed to the bathroom to put on the sheath and came out saying, "Definitely don't want nothing swimming up my penis." This was so embarrassing to Karine, who was in her normal swimwear. Number 2. Chantel's family wouldn't eat chicken feet. Despite Chantel and her Dominican fiancé, Pedro, going on well with their relationship, their families were not on terms and the feud kept growing by the day. Now, during a family dinner for the couple's second wedding in the Dominican Republic, Chantel's family realized that they had been intentionally served with chicken feet and neck. Realizing this setup, the family refused to eat, and this caused a scuffle between the two families. Chantel and Pedro intervened to no avail, and finally, Chantel's family angrily walked away. It was strange because in the end, even Pedro's family didn't eat the chicken legs and neck. Number 1. Kalani told her sister she was pregnant, again. Just before Kalani could bring her fiancé Azuelu to the US, she delivered a baby in her home state of California. She was lucky to receive support and childcare from her family, specifically her sister Colini. Now when Kalani realized that she was pregnant again, she was sure Colini would be disappointed. Eventually, Kalani decides to break the news to Colini during her bridal shower. "I know it's like disappointing news and like horrible timing right now, but I feel like either way if I told you it was bad." But dramatically, Colini, who seems overwhelmed with thoughts of how her sister will face financial troubles, walks away from their table, saying, "I don't want to do this." There you go. So which of the 10 moments is the most unbelievable? Let us know in the comment section below. If you found this video enjoyable, then be sure to leave a like and subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next episode. Bye!